the riddle riddle. The grey warbler. Grey warbler.
Sam Hamiora Gibson is native to the North Island of New Zealand, who has taken it upon himself to give back to the land that provides for him and his family. To Sam, conservation is more than just trapping invasive species. It's about achieving a balance that allows his native New Zealand fauna and flora to proliferate, that will allow Mother Nature to do what she does best.
So I'm Hamiora Gibson, or Sam Gibson, and we're in the beautiful Te Tai Rāwhiti. This is my home, this is my backyard, the beautiful east coast of New Zealand. The reason I do the work that I do, it's just been ingrained in me since I was a kid. My grandfather, he was an agricultural accountant up here on the east coast. He was a hunter, a fisherman. My parents were hippies, quite idealistic people, and they all took me into the bush, running around the bush. And I guess from there, I created this idea that all of those things are connected, but it's also our responsibility to look after the places that care for us, that feed us through the deer and the native vegetation that we forage, and the fish as well. So that's the big driver for me, is I'm out there trying to look after the landscapes that support me and my family. It's a no-brainer.
The spiky, the bush lawyer. If you drink that, bro, it'll knock you out. So you'll like wake up in the morning and be like, whoa, did I go to sleep?
Effort. As a hunter, we tend to hunt in a wide diversity of landscapes, and the areas that we hunt mostly up here are in remnant bush on public conservation lands. And so my work is to essentially enhance all of those species across those public conservation lands. And I know that most of us hunters here in New Zealand, when we go into the bush, we like to hear kiwi at night, and we like to see feel in the streams, and we actually like to walk through and be able to harvest enough vegetables to sustain us while we're on multi-day trips.
Little bird in the bush, but his song is the most beautiful. It's like a real, like, crescendo kind of song. So this is the reason that the huia developed its beak, hey? So this here's a pūriri moth.
I guess my work is to bring about a sense of balance and a sense of abundance of all things. So those birds, that native vegetation, but also super fat deer. If you're a trophy hunter, fat deer means really large antlers, and fat pigs as well. So it's my job to bring about that balance in the ecosystem so that everyone can eat and everyone can see an abundance of our native species as well. So that's my work, and that's why we should care about it. So I've always taken young people with me in the bush. It's just our culture. Like, we've got the older guys teaching the younger guys, and that's just a part of succession planning. And I've always had young people in the bush, and we've always learnt together. But having a son's just upped the ante on that. Like, it's something I'm super passionate about. But I'm also really self-conscious about not knowing enough too. You know, like, I reckon you can never do justice by our kids, but whatever I can pass on to my boy, I definitely try to do that. And I definitely try to, not to guide him too much. I let him ask me the questions in the bush about what he wants to know, about what's interesting to him. I'm real passionate about raising kids, and I'm real passionate about bringing kids up in our environments, because I reckon we mold to our environments. And if we're bringing kids up in the bush, they're gonna be great people. They're drinking good quality water, breathing good air, and be physically fit and all of that stuff. All of those things help mould our mentality. So, Eastern Whiolink is a hunter-led project, it's a fisherman-led project, and it's a mana whenua-led project. But essentially, we just got together as a group of hunters, we'd watched our kiwi slowly disappear and our feel, our blue duck slowly disappear over time, and we were quite scared by that because we love to see them in the bush. And we'd waited for a long, long time for Doc to hopefully do something about it. And Doc just kept getting their budget slashed left, right and centre. And our little piece of paradise wasn't a priority for them. So we just decided, it's our bush, we're the ones in here every week, we better do something about it. So got together as a group of people and we put our first 250 traps on the ground, and we had four pairs of blue ducks in our field left. And in the first season we killed enough stoats for them to successfully breed 20 young field. So that's it. That safeguarded the population. Those field have fledged into the surrounding streams, and our field, they're not going to collapse anytime soon. So that job's been done, which is massive. We probably limited ourselves with the name Whiolink because now we found kiwi in there. We're putting traps around those, and those guys are breeding. We found bats. We found Dokubita tusked weta. We found little endemic frogs with no eardrums. We found all sorts of creatures, eh?
That's why we do it.
And so the small hunter-led conservation project that started with seven of us has grown into a huge project with over 80 active volunteers. We just got given $700,000 from the government to employ some of our hunters on the block to do the trapping. So yeah, it's just gone from strength to strength, really. And we're just out there living the dream. It's not just trapping, it's not just conservation. Like, we're massive that whenever we're out on the block, you've got your gun, you've got your fishing rod, you've got your dogs. It's definitely providing, like, harvesting food is a big part of the project. That mucking a kai practice, understanding what's edible and not edible, that's just as much of the project as the conservation element is. So what the future holds for me is probably, I want to keep doing the work that I'm doing, but I want to step back to some degree and let some of our young people come through, start managing these projects, and I'll just move over and create the next project for those young people to come through and start managing and doing the work on the ground. Hopefully my son, he might become one of those workers, but yeah, I want to see ecosystems that are both abundant with native vegetation, with our game species, but also one day I'd love to get to such a point of abundance of our native bird species that we can get back to a point of harvesting them and those being part of our food sources in a contemporary context. That's my big driver. I want that for myself and I want that for my son. I'm Hamiora Gibson from Te Tairawhiti in New Zealand, and I'm a bushman.